Welcome everybody to this new lecture of our paper Waves, Oscillation and Acoustics. Today we will discuss about some new concepts related to simple harmonic motion and some bodies which perform simple harmonic oscillations. And in our previous lecture we were discussing about the simple pendulum, which time period is equals to t 2 pi root l by g, where l is the length of the string and g is the gravitational acceleration. And by this formula you can find the time period of a simple harmonic simple pendulum on Earth surface. Okay, so let us move forward and talking about the compound pendulum. Another mechanical example of a system which performing SHM. Okay, so a compound pendulum consists of a rigid body hoti hai, which can oscillate freely about a horizontal axis passing through it. Okay, this system is known as a compound pendulum. Okay, consider a rigid body of any shape, regular, irregular. Okay, consider a rigid body of any shape and mass m, capable of oscillating freely about a horizontal axis passes through it and perpendicular to its plane. Look at here, this is a compound pendulum, which is a regular or irregular body which have mass m and capable of oscillating about a line which is perpendicular, which is horizontally axis, which is perpendicular to its plane and passing horizontally through it. This body is considered as the compound pendulum. Okay, let O be the center of suspension of the body. Here is this point is O, by which this body is suspended from a rigid support, and G is its center of gravity. G. Okay, you look at it. G. Okay. Let's make it clear. So this G, okay, so G is its center of gravity. Vertically below O, this is vertically below at O, from at a distance L, this distance from O to G is L, in the position of rest. Okay, when the body is displaced by an angle of theta, this angle is theta. Okay, the center of gravity is shifted to the position G dash. This is the position, new position of center of gravity, G dash. Okay, and its weight mg acts vertically downward at G dash. This weight of this body is working vertically downward at G dash. So this is the conditions. The body is suspended from point O, the center of gravity is G, which is vertically below the point O, and the distance between the O and G is small l. The body is then shifted by an angle of this theta, and when this shifted by an angle of theta, then the center of gravity of this body is shifted to G dash, and the weight at point G dash is working vertically downward at the point G dash. Okay, so now if the pendulum is now released from point G dash, this dotted the dotted position is the new position, and the solid line represents the rest position of this compound pendulum. Now, if the pendulum is released, okay, is released, a restoring couple acts on it and it brings it back into the initial position. Restoring couple, हमेशा जो एक ऐसा फोर्स जो बॉडी के मूवमेंट के अगेंस्ट वर्क करे, एक्सेलरेशन आप उसे कहते हैं, एक्सेलरेशन के अगेंस्ट वर्क करे और ये कोशिश करे कि बॉडी रेस्ट की पोजीशन में आ जाए, तो ऐसे फोर्स को हम रेस्टोरिंग फोर्स कहते हैं। हमने इस फोर्स के बारे में SHM जब हमने डिस्कस किया था उस समय भी हमने कोशिश की थी कि कोई भी बॉडी जो परफॉर्म कर रही हो SHM सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन, तो उसमें एक फोर्स वर्क कर रहा है जो बॉडी के इस मोशन का अपोज करता है, दैट्स वाई दिस फोर्स इज नोन एज रेस्टोरिंग फोर्स। ओके, सो देयर एक्ट्स अ रेस्टोरिंग कपल एक्ट ऑन इट एंड ब्रिंग्स इट बैक टू द इनिशियल पोजिशन, बट ड्यू टू द इनर्शिया ऑफ दैट बॉडी इट ओवरशूट्स द मार्क एंड हैंस स्टार्ट ऑसिलेटिंग अबाउट द मेन पोजिशन। दिस इज अ नेचुरल फिनोमेना। द मोमेंट ऑफ रेस्टोरिंग कपल और टॉर्क, वट इज द टॉर्क? टॉर्क इज द मोमेंट ऑफ फोर्स, एंड वट इज द फोर्स हियर इज मास mg which acts downward, and g dash a, look at in this figure, what is g dash a? Look at in this figure, what is g dash a? G dash a is this distance from g dash to this point a. The vertical distance or perpendicular, you can see it as perpendicular distance from the line of action of force, and that is the definition of torque. That is the definition of torque. Torque is equal to the moment of force. Okay, and moment of force, that means the force into the distance of perpendicular, you can say perpendicular distance from the line of action of force. So line of action of force is this downward, and perpendicular distance is this is L sin theta. So G dash A is L sin theta. Why L sin theta? Because this distance is L, this angle is theta, this distance is L, so this distance is L sin theta, simply using sine rule in this right angle triangle. O A G dash, this is the right angle triangle at for which this angle A is right angle. So G dash A by the sine rule in this angle is in this triangle is L sine theta. And the moment of force, then what is the moment of force? The force multiplied by the perpendicular distance between the line of action from the line of action of force. Okay, so the torque, which is equal to the moment of force, okay, is equal to the moment of force, and mg into g dash a, and from the figure you see that g dash a is L sin theta. So torque acting on the compound pendulum is mg L sin theta, and put theta in place of sin theta as the angle is small. Okay, if I be the moment of inertia of the rigid body, that is this pendulum, okay, about an axis passing through its center of suspension, then torque is this. This is the relation between torque and angular acceleration. This is the relation. Tau is equal to I d2 theta over dt square. Where, from where it is coming? You know that we read this relation very well in that tau is equals to I alpha. This relation. Tau is equals to I alpha, where tau is the torque and I is moment of inertia of that body, and alpha is the angular acceleration. And because angular displacement is theta, because this why alpha is d2 theta over dt square? Because theta is the angular displacement, then d theta by dt is angular velocity, which is omega, and double differentiation of theta, that is the angular differentiation with respect to t, gives you the d2 theta over dt square, which is angular acceleration denoted by alpha. So this is the story behind this. Tau is equals to I d2 theta over dt square. From here, it is coming. So say this is equation number first, and this is equation number second. So the left hand side of these two equations are same. So the right hand side should be equal. So this is the right hand side of equation number 2, and this is the right hand side of equation number 1. So I d2 theta over dt square is equals to minus mgl theta, this term. Okay, and from here d2 theta over dt square is equals to mgl over I into theta. Okay, and you can deduce from this relation that d2 theta over dt square is proportional to theta, that is the angular displacement. Why? Because this quantity, look at this quantity, m, mass of the pendulum, constant, g, angular acceleration, is equals to 9.8 meter per second square, constant, l, this, the length, l, is fixed, constant, I, moment of inertia, is constant. So d2 theta over dt square, that is the angular acceleration, is directly proportional to angular displacement, as this quantity is constant. Okay, so what is time period of this compound pendulum? And the formula is this. Time period can be calculated by this formula. According to this formula, that time period t is equals to 2 pi root angular displacement over angular acceleration. The same formula here is. Look at here. This t is equals to 2 pi root 1 over angular acceleration per unit angular displacement. Per unit angular displacement, this means angular displacement over angular acceleration in the root of this. So simple is that time period of a compound pendulum or any pendulum is equals to 2 pi root angular displacement over angular acceleration. So angular displacement is theta. Here is, and angular acceleration alpha is mgl theta over I. Mgl theta over I. So theta is cancelled with theta. Theta is cancelled with theta, and we can write it as 2 pi I over mgl. This is equation number third. Okay, if IG is the moment of inertia of pendulum about an axis parallel to the given axis but passing through its center of gravity, then using theorem of parallel axis, and this is the statement of theorem of parallel axis, that the moment of inertia about an axis by which you want to find the moment of inertia is equals to the moment of inertia about an axis which passing through the center of gravity and parallel to this axis. Okay, plus m is the mass of that body, r is the distance between these two parallel axes, one which by which you want to find the moment of inertia, and other is that you already know the moment of inertia about that axis is passing through the center of gravity of that body, and the moment of inertia about the axis which passing through the center of gravity of compound pendulum like body is mk square, where k is the radius of gyration. Okay, plus m is the mass of the pendulum, and r is the distance between the two axes, and this is equal to l. So here is ml square. So I is equals to mk square plus l square. This is the radius of gyration. Okay, so substituting this value of I into equation number third, and equation number third is as we discussed earlier. So t is equal to 2 pi root in place of I is mk square plus ml square over mgl. M is constant common from the numerator as well as you see the m term in the denominator. So m is cancelled with m and you are left with 2 pi root k square plus l square over lg. Okay, and this is the time period of a compound pendulum. Okay, now talking about the minimum time period. What is the minimum time period of oscillation of compound pendulum? Okay, and minimum time period is calculated in this way. The time period of compound pendulum is minimum when distance of the point of suspension from CG, center of gravity, is equal to the radius of gyration. अगर ये हो जाए तो हम कहेंगे time period minimum हो गया. यानी जो distance of the point of suspension from the CG, center of gravity is the point of suspension का distance, that is L, is equal to the radius of gyration. अगर radius of gyration के equal हो जाए तो हम कहेंगे कि ये जो टाइम पीरियड है ये मिनिमम हो गया. तो हमें ये पता है कि टाइम पीरियड का ये फॉर्मूला में इक्वेशन नंबर 4 से अभी स्टडी करके आए हैं. सो t इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई रूट k स्क्वायर प्लस l स्क्वायर ओवर lg स्क्वायरिंग ऑन बोथ साइड्स. स्क्वायरिंग ऑन बोथ साइड्स, सो स्क्वायरिंग ऑन बोथ साइड्स गिव्स यू t स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू 4 पाई स्क्वायर इनटू k स्क्वायर प्लस l स्क्वायर ओवर lg. ओके, एंड यू आई कैन राइट इट इन दिस वे दैट 4 pi square over g into k square plus l square over l. Now differentiating this relation with respect to t, sorry, with respect to l, with respect to l. Okay, and this is the trick. What is the trick? Trick is that you studied the concept of maxima and minimum in your plus 2 syllabus somewhere in mathematics. And you know that this chapter maximum and minimum tells us that if you want to find the value, maximum value of any quantity, then differentiating that quantity, if you want to find the maximum value of any function, which is the function of time t, okay, so differentiating that function with respect to t, and then take that value equals to zero, then that gives you the maximum time period. Maximum value of that function. So here is the same trick. We divide this, differentiate this quantity with respect to L, then put dt by dl is equals to zero, and that gives me the condition by which this time period is minimum or maximum. Okay, minimum value gives me minimum, maximum value gives me maximum. Simple. So let us differentiate this equation with respect to L. We have that when we differentiating left hand side, so this differentiating this quantity with respect to L gives me dt by dl, so 2t dt by dl, the left hand side differentiation with respect to L, and on the right hand side, because 4 pi square over g is constant, so d by dl of this quantity, so k square over L and plus L, this k square over L plus L. Okay, so 4 pi square over g d by dl of this quantity minus k square over L square, and this the d by dl of L gives me plus 1. Okay, so for the value of time period to be minimum, मैंने आपसे अभी डिस्कस किया, आप कोई भी आपके पास t का फंक्शन, जैसे मान लीजिए मैं आपको बताऊं कि ये आपने कहीं प्लस टू के सिलेबस में मैथमेटिक्स में जरूर सीखा होगा कि मेरे पास दो फंक्शन cos ओमेगा t प्लस साइन ओमेगा t एंड विच इज द फंक्शन ऑफ y t. इस तरह का मेरे पास कोई फंक्शन और मैं इस फंक्शन की मिनिमम मैक्सिमम वैल्यू पर, तो मैं क्या करूं, डी वाई बाई डी टी करें और इसके इक्वल जीरो रखें. यहां से आपको जो भी कंडीशन मिलेंगे वापस इस रिलेशन में रखें, तो इस फंक्शन का मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम वैल्यू आपको मिल जाएगी. ओके, सो लेट्स डू दैट. ओके, So this 2t dt by dl, the differentiation of left hand side with respect to L gives me this quantity, and 4 pi square over g is constant, so d by dl of this quantity can be written as k square over L plus L, and the differentiation of this quantity with respect to L gives me minus k square over L square, because this is into the denominator, so gives me minus 1 over L square, so that's why this quantity becomes minus k square over L square plus 1, because the differentiation d by dl of L, that is the differentiation with respect to L of L, is always 1. D by dt of t is always 1. Okay, so for the value of time period to be minimum, dt by dl should be equal to 0. This dt by dl should be equal to 0. Then if this quantity is 0, then usually this right hand side should be equal to 0. So look at here, this quantity. So k square minus k square plus L square plus 1 is equal to 0. Why is this equal to 0? Because look at here, dt by dl equal to 0 for the minimum value of this quantity, this should be equal to 0, and that's why left hand side is 0. That's why this quantity, the right hand side should be equal to 0, because 4 pi square over g is constant, cannot be equal to 0. So minus k square over L square plus 1 should be equal to 0. So minus k square over L square plus 1 is equals to 0, or should be equal to 0. Or you can say it as L has value plus minus k. So further, d2t over dl square, that is the double differentiation of this equation with respect to L, comes out to be positive if L equals to plus minus k. Positive aega to minimum value, maximum negative aega to maximum. ये पहले से ही रूल है. ओके, यहाँ से जो मैंने अभी आपके साथ डिस्कस किया था, इस फंक्शन को आप डिफ्रेंशिएट कीजिए, इसको जीरो कीजिए, यहाँ से कोई रिलेशन आएगा आपके पास, कोई कंडीशन निकल के आएगी, उस कंडीशन को वापस इस इक्वेशन को आप डी टू वाई बाई डी टी स्क्वायर उस कंडीशन के साथ इसका कीजिए, उस इक्वेशन के साथ जो यहाँ से रिजल्ट आया उसको वापस यहाँ पुट कीजिए, डी टू वाई बाई डी टी स्क्वायर कीजिए, उस कंडीशन को यहाँ पुट कीजिए. अगर ये वैल्यू आपको पॉजिटिव आती है तो ये इस फंक्शन की मिनिमम वैल्यू होगी, और अगर ये वैल्यू आपको निगेटिव आती है तो ये इस फंक्शन की मैक्सिमम वैल्यू. दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट, यू ऑल स्टडीड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट डेफिनेटली इन योर मैथमेटिक्स सिलेबस इन प्लस टू. ओके, सो फर्दर इफ वी कैलकुलेट डी टू टी ओवर डी एल स्क्वायर कम्स आउट टू बी पॉजिटिव इफ एल इक्वल टू plus minus k. Okay, so put this result into here. T minimum is 2 pi root, because the relation is this equation number 4, T, the time period of compound pendulum is equals to 2 pi root k square plus L square over Lg. Put k is equals to L here, or L equals to k here, so the relation is, relation becomes k square plus k square, because L is equals to plus k or minus k, but square gives you always gives you plus k. So k square plus k square is 2k square over kg, k is cancelled with k, and 2 pi root k by 2k by g. This is the minimum time period of that compound pendulum. Okay, so this is about the time period and minimum time period of a compound pendulum which performing SHM. This is another mechanical example of a body which performing, or a system which performing SHM. Now moving to third example, which is the LC circuit, which is an electrical example of a system which performing SHM. LC circuit के बारे में भी आप कहीं ना कहीं plus two level पे जब इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स वाला पार्ट आपने स्टडी किया होगा, एसी करंट का जो सिलेबस है वहाँ वो सिलेबस स्टडी किया होगा, तो जरूर आपने यहाँ ये एलसी सर्किट वाला कंसेप्ट जरूर आपकी स्टडी में आया होगा। सो लेट्स डिस्कस दिस कंसेप्ट, द एलसी सर्किट। ओके, व्हाट इज एलसी सर्किट? एलसी सर्किट को हम बहुत सारे नामों से जानते हैं, एलसी सर्किट, रेजोनेंट सर्किट, टैंक सर्किट, एलसी टैंक सर्किट, ट्यून्ड सर्किट, इतने सारे नाम हैं इसके। एलसी सर्किट जाना किसलिए जाता है? जाना इसलिए जाता है कि एलसी सर्किट में जब कोई करंट फ्लो होती है, कोई इनपुट दिया जाता है एलसी सर्किट को, तो इसमें ऑसिलेशन होने स्टार्ट हो जाते हैं, और ऑसिलेशन जब होते हैं तो ऑसिलेशन में जब फ्रीक्वेंसी रेस्पॉन्स, हम इसका एलसी सर्किट का यहाँ तो शायद नहीं स्टडी करेंगे, पर जहाँ आपने स्टडी किया होगा तो एक इस तरह का लेट मी ड्रॉ इट इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, यू प्रोबेबली और परहैप्स स्टडी दिस। इस तरह का एक फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स, दैट इज गेन वर्सेस फ्रीक्वेंसी ग्राफ। दिस इज द गेन वर्सेस फ्रीक्वेंसी ग्राफ ऑफ एलसी सर्किट। ओके, तो इस तरह का हम स्टडी करते हैं अबाउट एलसी सर्किट के फिनोमिना ऑफ ऑसिलेशन, एंड विच टाइप ऑफ ऑसिलेशन? सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशन। तो एलसी सर्किट को जब किसी बैटरी से कनेक्ट किया जाता है उसमें ऑसिलेशन स्टार्ट होते हैं। किस तरह के ऑसिलेशन स्टार्ट होते हैं? सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशन स्टार्ट होते हैं, इसीलिए ये इंक्लूड किया गया है एज एन इलेक्ट्रिकल एग्जांपल ऑफ सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशन और द बॉडी और द सिस्टम विच परफॉर्मिंग एज सच। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टडी अबाउट दिस। दिस इज अबाउट एलसी सर्किट। So consider an electrical circuit in which an inductor L of inductance L and of negligible resistance is connected to a capacitor of capacitance C. In which way it is connected? Let's see. When the capacitor is start and connected in this way, parallel to each other. You can say it as this. This is C, the capacitor, and here is the inductor. This LC connected in this way. Okay. So make an LC circuit. You named it as LC circuit. LC circuit, you can say it as resonant circuit because there is a phenomenon of resonance here. Resonant circuit, you can say it as a tank circuit, LC tank circuit, or you can say it as tuned circuit because it can be tuned to a particular frequency. So tuned circuit, tank circuit, resonant circuit, LC circuit, they are different things, and this is its frequency response. Whether it can be used in this topic or not. Okay, so this is the system, that is L and C is connected in this way. Okay, so what is the performance? What is about working mechanism of this circuit? Okay, so when the capacitor starts charging and by means of a battery, charging kab hoga? Jab aap kisi battery se connect karenge use. Okay. When the capacitor starts charging by means of a battery, the electrostatic energy resides between the plate of capacitor. Plate of capacitor mein electrostatic energy ke form mein wo store ho jati hai wo energy. And the capacitor begins to discharge through the inductor. Aur jab wo pura charge ho gaya to uske baad wo fir inductor ke through डिस्चार्ज होना शुरू करता है, और वहाँ इस सर्किट में एक करंट फ्लो हो जाती है शुरू, एक करंट स्टार्ट फ्लो इन द इंडक्टर कॉइल। ओके, this set up a magnetic field, because if a current is flow through a coil, it sets up a magnetic field across this coil. We studied this concept very well in electricity and magnetism course. So a current starts flow through the inductor coil. This sets up a magnetic field around the coil. Okay, as the capacitor discharges, the electrostatic energy of the capacitor converted into the magnetic field energy of inductor, and thus a continuous exchange of energy between the inductor and capacitor takes place. As resistance is negligible, you know here that inductor of inductance L and negligible resistance, there is no dissipation of energy in the form of heat or as extra form of dissipation of energy. So if L is the coefficient of self-inductance of the coil and di by dt is the rate of growth of the current, then this is our LC circuit. This is our LC circuit in which L and C is connected in this way. There is a battery which connected to this capacitor in this way, and here is a key K. So when the K is connected to A, okay, so the battery is connected to the capacitor. Battery is connected to the capacitor and capacitor starts charging. And when it is then connected to the point B, the capacitor starts discharges through the inductor coil L. And you very well know that when a current is flowing through a coil, this sets up a magnetic field around this coil. So actually the phenomena is that when you connect this key to point A, the capacitor starts charging and it stores this energy, the electrostatic energy between these two plates. And when it is fully charged, then if you connect this key to point B, then there is no connection of battery to the capacitor, then capacitor starts discharging through this inductor. And when this current is coming to this coil sets up a magnetic field, or a magnetic field is set up around the coil. That means this electrostatic energy which stores in between the plates of capacitor is changing over the magnetic field energy of this coil. This is the concept of LC circuit. And it is continuously done. When it is fully discharged, there is no current, then again this point is connected to this is again charging, storing the electrostatic energy in between these plates, and when again this point is connected to B, this capacitor C is start discharging through this inductor coil, and this cycle is repeated again and again. Okay, so this is the working mechanism of a LC circuit. Okay, and I proposed here that the current rate change of current is d by dt in this inductor coil, and inductance of this coil is L. Then the voltage across this inductor is minus dL di by dt. That is the inductor and rate change of current, and this can be written as L dq by dt. Again, the double differentiation of charge, single differentiation of charge, L di by dt, double differentiation of charge. okay, because a single differentiation, that is the time rate change of charge, gives you the current. And time rate change of current gives you this D2Q. Let's see here. The definition of current. What is the definition of current? Okay. What is the definition of current? The definition of current is that I, the current I, can be mathematically described by this equation dq by dt. Mathematically described by this equation dq by dt. That is the time rate change of charge is equal to the current flowing in that particular circuit. Or you can say it, the amount of charge passing through a point per unit time is known as the current I. Okay, this is a wire, this is the charge flowing in this wire Q. So through this point, per unit time, per unit second, per unit minute, per minute, per hour, how much the amount of charge is passing through this point is known as current. Okay, so current is actually the time rate change of charge. And if you deduce the time rate change of current, so again differentiating it by d by dt of dq by dt will gives you d2q over dt square. So actually di by dt can be written as d2q over dt square. That's why we write this in this way. Okay, so the voltage across the inductor is L di by dt, and the equation becomes this minus L d2q over dt square. So voltage across capacitor V is equal to Q by C, simple. So there is no source of EMF in the circuit, so why L d2q by dt square, that is the voltage across the inductor plus the voltage across the capacitor should be equal to zero, because in this circuit, the upper circuit, there is no source of EMF. If there is a source of EMF, then the right hand side does not equal to zero according to Kirchhoff's law. If there is a source of EMF, then definitely there is a term on the right hand side of this equation. So in this circuit, because there is no source of EMF, so this equation becomes L d2q over dt square plus q by c is equal to 0. Okay, so the equation can be rewrite, this equation can be rewrite in this way, that dtq over dt square plus q over lc, because this L is coming here into the denominator of q. So this equation can also be rewrite as dtq over dt square plus mu q, and this quantity 1 over LC, this 1 over LC can be written as mu, which is a constant. L, the value of inductor, C, the value of capacitor, capacitance, inductance, always constant, reverse of this, always constant. So this is the differential equation. This is equation number 1. Okay, and because this is a constant, we can write equation number 1 as dtq over dt square is proportional to minus q. Is proportional to minus. Hence, the discharge of the capacitor is oscillatory. This equation suggests us the same equation as we studied for the SHM. Same equation. Restoring force equation, actually. This. So the time period, what is the time period? So time period is T 2 pi 1 over mu, this. So 2 pi LC, because 1 over mu gives you LC. This is equation number 2. And frequency, what is the frequency? Reciprocal of time period, that is 1 over 2 pi root LC. So equation number one, because equation number one is the differential equation of SHM for electrical circuit, its solution can be written as. And this is the same solution as we write for the solution of this type, A sine omega t plus phi. This is the same solution as we write. But this is for displacement, this is for charge. So solution of this equation can be written as, where Q naught is the maximum value of charge. So this is the time period of LC circuit and this is the frequency. Okay, and this is very much similar solution to this one. Okay, so that's all for now, and meet you into the next one. Thank you.